Hi, good morning, everybody. Kind of want to make a video about the new hero, kind of do a little bit of an event analysis and go from there. First off, I want to say to everyone that's out there, stay happy, stay healthy. Kind of a really unprecedented time, and so many people aren't working a lot. Maybe some people are working too much based on your industry. Thank you to all you first-line responders, healthcare industry people. You guys are putting in a lot of hours for a lot of us, so I wanted to say thank you to all of you guys for really making it happen. So now let's get back to a good distraction. So first off, the event is not bad. The calendars and what have you. I did get the Pixie Pass, so we'll go into that in just a bit. First thing I want to talk about is, as always, is the deals. The keys, I have mixed feelings about the keys, and I'll tell you why. So when they reduced the doors from 14 to 10, it makes it to where you can only 5-star a hero, right? So right here, I can get 20 gold keys for 150 for a 5-star hero. Normally, I just always bought the 2 for 14, so I'd spend $200 on one of these events, and I'd get a 6-star hero. Albeit that's not just simply not an option this time around. So sometimes you spend $200, sometimes you spend even more. So you can spend $150, get and open all the keys with a gold door and a few extras with gold keys from the free ones and the ones from the shop. So either you can look at it like you devalue the calendar or you increase the value of your keys, however you want to look at it. Event shop. Gold keys are priced right once again. 5K gems is a steal for, you know, all the stuff you get with a gold key. You know, you think about, you normally would spend 7,500 gems on an elite rune, no problem. So you're spending 5K gems, get an elite rune, you get portal pulls, you get hero tokens. I mean, it's just an absolutely no-brainer. Gold keys, currency-wise, it's 40K suns, another good deal. The bronze silver keys, once again, priced correctly. The enable runes I thought were good if you don't have your malice or like your pontifex enabled yet. Now is a great time to do that. The elite shield piercing rune, absolutely amazing rune. I strongly suggest it for your Dagons, for your Aurias, your Jin Lees, people that need shield piercing runes, and it's pretty good value. So we went from 5 for 75 to 10 for 120. So they did reduce the actual cost of the portal pull. So I wanted to say thank you. A lot of time in MFG chat, and I know you guys don't know this, but I spend a lot of time, and I try to give healthy criticism. I try not to get too emotionally involved, but guys, I love this game. I absolutely love this game. And I know our devs love this game too. And so sometimes they get a lot of crap from me, and I don't mean to come off as rude or mean, but like I care a lot about this game, and I care a lot about this game being successful. So I did want to say thank you for at least making this make a little bit more sense as far as sending event currency on portal pulls. On this event, now you can be bent out of shape about this if you want, but there's no reason to be bent out of shape. Simply run the event dungeon manually, and you'll get loot keys and raid tickets. This is actively discouraging you from spending your event tickets on any of this stuff, minus the gold, maybe. I don't know if you need gold. But anyway, just run the event dungeon, and you'll do really good. I feel like they've done really good with that. So now let's get into Lorelei, because this would not be a creepy, authentic production without some new hero goodness. Now, Lorelei, she's a fast, arcane healer. Really good hero design, really balanced. I'm admittedly not the biggest fan of her. I think she has limited value, especially with Null Magic running amok, and I'll get into that rant in just a bit. So let's go on her stats. Lorelei is a clever fairy. She turned her gift of flight into a curse for her enemies. Fast. So, real quick, before I finish this out, I'm sorry, I gotta say this. We are piling way too much power in the fast slot. It almost does you no good to have medium or slow hero. The only slow hero that you're even going to think about using right now is Jin Lee. He's the only one that you'll even think about using. And even then, he's bypassed because a lot of these fast heroes are silence immune statted. Sybils, Archons, they're silence immune statted. You're going to enable Dagon, so it doesn't matter if he's silenced or not. This person I probably is going to have Foresight on her, so yeah. Too much power in the fast spot. But anyway, she's fast. Flying takes less damage from melee attacks. Takes less damage from non-physical attacks. This hero gets 10% health, defense, and skill for each magical hero in the room. So that's not just your team. So if you go fight an ultra-magical team and you bring an ultra-magical team, she can literally have 70% more health, skill, defense. She self-builds really well like that. That's a good ability. Flying allies heal at the end of each round. So if you cast Gift of Flight, she'll heal all allies for 3 rounds, even if they're normally not flying. Here's the good one. Here's a really good ability. Time will tell if she really changes things. But it's You Can't Catch Me. Flying allies can't have buffs removed or debuffs added by non-flying enemies. Now, this is a direct nerf to Sybil. And I know people don't like the word nerf, and so they won't announce a nerf, but they're going to create an ability that immediately nerfs Sybil. So now, a hard counter to like a Sybil first team, just bring Lorelei. It's super easy. Bring Lorelei and some dragons, and now their Sybil doesn't do anything. So, but it is a great ability. So now you don't necessarily have to bring Nivius, and Valken can't freeze your Alrakas, for example. Arcane heroes' attacks have a chance to buff other allies' attacks. So if you're wanting to buff an attack versus defense somebody right away, just use her S1. It can't miss. And Gift of Flight is what it is. It's going to buff your hero's attack because you're going to have extra skill. Mine's built about like this right now. It's currently pretty very defensive because she's only 3 stars. So we've got to really take care of her. Once again, the all-important skill over 3K. And yes, I start that right away. So let's go over Dust in the Eye. Ranged light attack on a target enemy for 655 base damage reduces defense and skill by... And it doesn't say skill by any percentage. That's a mistake on their part. We've already reported it to them. But it reduces skill, reduces defense. That's what you need to know. Gift of Flight. Ranged light attack on all enemies for 1191 base damage that grants flying and heals for 5014 split between all allies. Knocks enemies off balance. This attack cannot be dodged. So if you want to save this for like round 2, I'll go into some beta talk soon, but that's really good, especially if you have like an Aria on the team and you make Aria flying and then you make people off balance and now they're in a spot where they can't continually can't hit Aria and you continually have damage reduction. Anyway, we'll get into more of that in a bit. Magic Prism. For 3 turns, redirects 100%, 107% damage and healing from target ally to a random enemy, stealing buffs and transferring debuffs. So the simplest way to explain this is just imagine Spirit Link. But instead of Spirit Link on Shade to another person, it's you can pick an ally and the link will go to a random enemy. And that's really good, and I'll show you why in just a bit. Oh, this needs 1 festive rune to execute immediately, just like Shade Spirit Link. I strongly suggest, and by strongly I mean it should be mandatory, that you put magic 1 festive rune on Lorelei, and I'll show you why in just a bit when we get in the PvP segment. Trixie Fae heals all allies for 5014 split between all allies and applies heal over time. Ranged light attack on it, random enemy for 1853 base damage that transfers all debuffs on target ally and 1 from each other ally. So you pick the target that you want this to affect, It'll transfer all their debuffs away from them, one from everyone else, and heals for 5,014 base damage. Heals 5,014 health and does a base damage of 1,853. It's a pretty good ability, and the more she gets started up, the better she gets. There is no epic. Now, let's do some PvP. I've been testing a lot, so I've lost a lot this season. Guys, don't judge me. I'm playing around having a lot of fun. So let's go right into using her. Now, there are certain teams that she still cannot touch. If you see, for example, the Dagon, Archon, Serenity, Balkan teams, don't even think about using Trixie yet, because you will get mercilessly curb stomped. So on this situation, I'm going to bring my dragons, Nivea's first. Draconic Hourglass goes off, that way I get better damage. And we're going to use Ferno. Now, there's a few things here that you've really got to pay attention to. Because I have one Festive and I have four sights on her, there we go. Now, people you don't want to die. You do not want Nivea's to die. If Nivea's dies, this whole attack goes to hell in a handbasket really fast. So I'm going to Magic Prism. No need for me to do anything right now. Okay? So I'm going to ensure survival. Now, we're not taking any damage. And I hope they kill Ferno. Kill him. I dare you to kill him. Come on. All right, so right here we go. We'll just go right into attacking her. I'm just going to kill him. Oh, wow. Holy shit. I don't know how he didn't die from that. That's all right. That'll kill him. So, real quick. It's super important to know when to use You Can't Catch Me and to know when to use Magic Prism. Magic Prism is absolutely amazing for keeping the right person alive. Now, Shield Piercing, just so you guys know, Shield Piercing, just like with Spirit Link, will still get through it. So it's super important that you don't... Oh, yeah, kill me, you slut. See, there we go. See, this is why we do this. Now we've got sustainability. Anything that you do now will damage their Jin Li. Look at me alive. Look at me alive. And guess who's still alive to do this? This guy is. Oh, that's so nice. Oh, that's so amazing. Oh, you're so awesome. And here we go. Well, there's that. So that's a great way to use Lorelei for the dragons. Just link up your man Nivea's. Make sure you have an aversion rune on him. He will guarantee a survival. Now, another great way to use him is if you use like where's Hazuki at? So you guys already seen my Undead Resurgence video. This is a great, 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 great combo because this will create a spot where our man is flying. Okay? Come on, bring him in. Yes. So now I'm just going to go into flying mode. And real quick, I've said this before, but I'll say it again. Always have an aversion rune on Nivea's. Never not have an aversion rune on Nivea's. If you don't have an aversion rune on Nivea's, well then, I don't know. I guess I don't understand you. That's what it comes down to, is I don't understand you if you don't have one. So now, here we go with the Draconic Anger, and because Hansuki's on the team and he's undead, normally that would have generated follow-ups. But Hansuki's flying now, so he takes even less damage from attacks that he'd rather parry and all sorts of stuff. It's just absolutely wonderful. That's a monster waste of time. That's really good. Oh, come on. All right. I'll try to find one more good defense. Now, if you're using Lorelei with, like, Aria, she already gives you amazing damage reduction. We talked about that Fairy Dust earlier. I'm just going to see if I can kill everyone here. I think they're on Ruins, so should be able to kill everyone, yeah. If you have an Aria on your team, you definitely want to link her against dwarves, because now they're going to do dwarven resolve damage to Aria, which is absolutely amazing. So, and I guarantee their survival. And then in round one, what you're going to do is you're going to use the Gift of Flight. And once again, it can't miss. And it's going to take everyone off balance yet again. So right here, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to Magic Prism myself, Trixie. Yep, I knew you'd target her, you skank. I knew you would. Oh, man. I'm not going to revive anyone here, but I just want to get this fight over with. Normally, I'd do some sort of teaching there, but I'd really like to see a dwarf defense. Never thought you'd hear me say that, did you? You skank. Okay, well, for the sake of time, longer videos I found lose people's attention. But let's say you use this. Let's say you use, where's Serenity? Where's that skank Serenity at? We'll use here, and let's just use Pontifex. Now, the person that's most important in this attack is our Aria, because we want her to use Dust in the Eyes. We've already built her. You know, if you watch my videos earlier, you know that we build our Aria to use Dust in the Eyes. So now I'm going to Magic Link her. And now any damage done to Aria, I'll just silence this guy. I would normally silence Lawrence Falcon, but I want him to do AoE so he damages people. See how he's there frozen? Now right here, once again, this is a targeting thing. Do not target Dagrin first, because if you kill him first, he's going to activate the shield first. And if he activates the shield first, no one takes any damage. So we're going to target Hagrim, take him down, and then it goes clockwise from there. So long story short, put a festive on Our Lady Lorelei. Make sure you Magic Prism Nivius if you're using dragons. Make sure you Magic Prism Aria if she's against dwarves and you're using her. A pretty solid hero. She's not game-breaking by any means, but she is really solid, very balanced. So I like her. Decent event. I really wish there was thresholds. Really wish there was incentive to play every day, because really there's not. And there's some quests that you simply can't do if you're a beginning-level character. Squashing 5 Evos is not an option. You're holding on to those like Rose held on to Jack. And last but certainly not least, we still have a lot of problems with Our Lady Serenity. Null Magic is literally just rolling his dice, sacrificing a chicken, rubbing your lucky magic rabbit's foot. It's it's complete ridiculous. Said it once in several chats, and I'll say it again here. The only way for Null Magic to operate well is it should be where you Null Magic only applies after the battle's begun. So all your fourth set runes are intact. All your synergies are intact. So your shroud is intact. Your any passives that heroes give each other are intact. But the stack of Null Magic should block the next applied buff. The next apply buff. Because as it stands, folks, there are so many things we're robbed of in the meta. I would love to just abuse the heck out of Agnon right now. Agnon would be so much fun. The problem is, even though he's flying, even though he's on a team with Lorelei, Serenity can still start him out outside of stone form, which is absolutely ridiculous. Robs us of our lilies. Robs us of our kelpies. It robs us of a lot. Serenity's Null Magic needs absolutely fixed, along with her stopping all followed up and ranged retaliation. Anyway, I hope you guys liked the video. I hope you guys enjoy Lorelei if you get a user. She's worth the suns if you get her tokens out of the shop. She's pretty fun and creates another wrinkle for the game. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. Have a good day.